The University of Cincinnati College of Allied Health Sciences is home to over 50 health-related programs, minors, and certificates. We are standing in the Health Sciences Building, which is 117,000 square feet, four stories tall, and consists of labs, clinics, and interprofessional spaces. Its location cultivates unique hands-on learning opportunities that propel students into promising futures. Our observation hours, clinical placements, research, and job opportunities are greatly enhanced by our proximity to notable medical facilities, such as the University of Cincinnati Medical Center, TriHealth, Mercy Health, and the number one children's hospital in the nation, Cincinnati Children's. Hi, I'm Greer, a student in the College of Allied Health Sciences, and I'll be showing you around today. If you want to come check us out in person, we have several opportunities throughout the year where you can view our facilities, and we've linked more information below. We are currently in the atrium, which houses many modern features, such as these beautiful floor-to-ceiling windows. The open concept study spaces on each floor create a calming and pleasant environment for students to catch up with friends and do some homework. The atrium each year will showcase research, celebrate student achievements, as well as welcoming esteemed guests. Next, we'll showcase the student lounge. Follow me. Over here, you'll be able to find our student lounge. Inside, students are able to access fridges, microwaves, and Keurig coffee machines, ideal for on-campus students like myself. Each floor of this building houses labs and classroom spaces for students of every major within our academic college to practice as they learn. Now, the College of Allied Health Sciences has six undergraduate on-campus majors: social work, medical laboratory sciences, advanced medical imaging technology, health sciences, nutrition and dietetics, and speech language hearing sciences. Now, I'm gonna send you to a few students who are gonna talk a little bit more about the programs and the facilities that our academic college houses. And I'll see you on the third floor.
Hi, I'm Kiera, a fourth year in the Bachelor's of Social Work program here at UC. Social workers work with individuals, families, groups, and communities to solve and cope with everyday problems.
The social work interview room is on the first floor. The space is designed with two distinct sections divided by a wall and a double-sided mirror, intended to provide a sense of privacy during observations.
And it's a great place to do some self-reflection.
It is nice to have spaces like this one because the initial practice of vital skills like interviewing and group facilitation are often anxiety-provoking when first demonstrated. Having a smaller space where you can practice these skills outside the classroom is important to building confidence. Practicing in the interview room has helped me transition my knowledge and skills to my field placement.
Up next is the other side of the first floor.
Thanks, Kiera. Hi, my name is Danny and I'm a medical laboratory science major in my fourth year. Welcome to the lab.
Medical laboratory scientists correlate findings from lab results to diagnose patients. Approximately 70% of medical decisions are based on lab results. One of my favorite features of our lab is the professional microscopes that help us learn microscopy.
In our lab, we identify normal and abnormal cells, bacteria, and fluid and tissue samples. Come take a look.
We also grow disease-causing organisms by culturing infected sites from the body and performing tests to identify the bacteria. This environment has allowed me to actively engage in collaborative medical case studies as part of my coursework. This hands-on experience lets me hone my skills.
I'm excited to apply the lab policies and procedures I've learned here in the student lab to my 12-week clinicals. I hope you've enjoyed taking a closer look here at the lab. Now I'll hand it over to my friend Grace in the imaging lab.
Thanks, Danny. Hi, I'm Grace. I'm a second year student in the Advanced Medical Imaging Technology program. Once I graduate from UC's program, I will have the unique ability to practice in two areas, nuclear medicine and magnetic resonance imaging.
Our lab space on the second floor provides plenty of designated space and equipment to practice both modalities. Here in the imaging lab, we practice venipuncture, the puncture of a vein as part of a medical procedure, typically to administer contrast or radiopharmaceuticals for imaging. Additionally, we use anatomical models to learn anatomy, which is important when recognizing irregularities that help diagnose and treat patients.
We practice educating our patients on the do's and don'ts of our procedures and how to safely move patients from one surface to another, such as from a stretcher to an imaging bed.
Patients and their caregivers can be injured, or the quality of their images may suffer if the patient is positioned improperly or made uncomfortable by the equipment we use, which is often loud and confining.
Thanks for stopping by. Now you're headed upstairs to the Health Sciences Lab.
Hi, I'm Alec. I'm a second year in the Health Sciences Pre-Physical Therapy track.
Hi, I'm Caden. I'm a third year in the Health Sciences program on the Pre-PT track. Within the Health Sciences major, students can choose from several different tracks correlating to various graduate degrees. These include Pre-Physical Therapy, Pre-Physician's Associate, Pre-Occupational Therapy, Pre-Medicine, Pre-Pharmacy, Pre-Athletic Training, and Undecided. Your VO2 levels look great, by the way.
We should have measured yours. That was a lot of information right there.
The oxygen, or VO2 measurement, provides insight into the stress associated with the work being performed. We can use treadmills and bicycles to measure the heart rate. At a clinical level, they can be used as a component of diagnostic testing.
Force plates can be used to assist measure walking mechanical efficiency and gait measurements. We also use them for balance and sway measurements, which help our understanding of fall and prevention without causing harm to injured areas.
Additionally, working with skeletal models helps us visualize movement and memorize anatomy.
Looks like it's almost time for lunch. I wonder what they got cooking for us across the hall in the foods lab.
Hi everyone, welcome to the Food and Nutrition Lab. I'm Johanna and I'm a third year in the Nutrition and Dietetics program. The food lab contains all the materials needed to participate in hands-on cooking courses. Here, we learn cooking skills, food science, and how food can be used as medicine to treat and prevent chronic diseases. Students can educate future patients and clients about how to modify what goes into the foods they eat and ultimately eat a healthier diet. Our lab is full of useful appliances such as stand mixers, ovens, stoves, and commercial refrigerators. The lab has a variety of utensils that we use to practice cooking skills. I love improving my skills with technology, like the TV we use for demos and our iPads, which are handy for following recipes and allowing us to review and refine our techniques.
Hey, do you want to hear a joke about nutrition? Never mind, it looks like we're out of time.
Heard you loud and clear, Johanna. Hi, I'm Lydia, a fourth year studying speech-language-hearing sciences. Speech-language-hearing sciences majors typically go on to graduate school to become either a speech-language pathologist or an audiologist. We're in the speech-hearing clinic on the third floor. Here, we can observe and serve a variety of patients. The clinic is an impactful location to apply knowledge of speech, language, and hearing services that range from basic screenings to highly specialized treatment of complex conditions. Students aiming to attend graduate school must complete 25 service hours. Our in-house clinic is conveniently one of many locations where students can observe, practice, and research. Students like me use the resources in the Speech and Hearing Clinic to complete our capstone projects. Take it away, Greer.
Thanks, Lydia. I hope you enjoyed getting to view some of our undergraduate spaces. In addition to our world-class labs and classrooms, you'll be able to find your support system right here in the Health Sciences building.
Our next stop is designed to cater to the holistic needs of students, offering accessible resources and support to ensure a well-rounded academic journey. Inside the advising suite on the third floor, you'll find an embedded counseling and psychological services clinician who assists students in navigating a variety of mental and emotional challenges. The Student Success Coach connects students with helpful resources, events, tips, and models throughout their undergraduate experience. The advisors are expertly equipped to offer personalized academic guidance aligned with the unique goals of the students that they support.
Everyone, that wraps up this space. I'll meet you back down on the ground floor to show off some additional spaces in the building. See you down there. This is the Learning Commons. It's used as a dedicated space for independent and collaborative study. Now, during high pressure periods like finals week, this space is used for various learning styles and schedules. Just around the corner is UC's Bearcat Pantry satellite location.
The Bearcat's Pantry is a university-wide resource available to all UC students in need of food resources.
Fresh air, anyone? Awesome. Our last stop is Eden Commons. Let's go. Eden Commons is a 1.5 acre green space right here outside of the Health Sciences building. When the weather's super nice, you can typically find students out on the green space doing some studying, throwing around a hacky sack, or admiring the many fabulous medical facilities right in walking distance of this green space. Behind me, that's Progression by Albert Paley. It was found on Park Avenue in New York City, but now it's finally found its permanent home right here on Eden Commons. Well, That concludes our tour for today, folks. Links to more information will be posted below. Have a fabulous day, and go Bearcats!